please join me in welcoming to the new dating game, the current Mr. Olympia, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
So in a recent video, I spoke about a study on blame contagion that used a story about Arnold Schwarzenegger.
The story detailed a failure of Schwarzenegger's when he was the governor of California. In one version, he took full responsibility for his failure. And in the alternate version, he blamed other people. The group exposed to this blame shifting were twice as likely to blame others for their personal mistakes.
And then I wondered, how many times has Arnold Schwarzenegger been mentioned in scientific studies? And then this question consumed me. The answer, it gets a little out of hand.
As I turned to Google Scholar, I figured there were probably a handful of political science papers on Schwarzenegger's time as governor, possibly some fitness or bodybuilding studies, and definitely a few things referencing his films.
Who is your daddy and what does he do?
I grossly underestimated the scientific impact of Arnold Schwarzenegger.
First of all, it turns out he's a great example for common problems in information and data sciences. Like, how do you know if a name in your database is a duplicate? Or if there are just two people with the same name? Hint, Arnold Schwarzenegger is always a duplicate. In a table of US citizens, Arnold Schwarzenegger is a very rare name. And strangely enough, he's also a helpful example because his name is so hard to spell. What if someone is searching for Arnold Schwarzenegger? How does your search know who they're talking about? Well, there's a paper on that too, on how we can optimize search algorithms to look for results that are similar rather than exact matches. To be honest, most of the information science and mathematical linguistics papers were very complex.
Automatic fine-grained entity typing by hierarchical partial label embedding. Sure.
So luckily, they're just the tip of the iceberg.
The Iceman cometh.
Apart from just using his name, there seems to be a study looking at every part of Arnold's career. He's kind of done everything.
I'm pregnant.
So what makes him such a popular choice to be used in research? Schwarzenegger sits at the intersection of many cultural spaces and academic fields of study. Also, he's just a fun example.
That's true.
Looking at Arnold as a professional bodybuilder, he's mentioned in a paper talking about sarcopenia, or the degradation of muscles with age. And he's also mentioned in a paper looking at the attractiveness of averages versus extremes. Spoiler, Arnold sex symbol Schwarzenegger falls into the attractive extreme category. And the scientific paper does call him a sex symbol, so that's confirmed by science, I suppose? He's also mentioned, unsurprisingly, in papers on nutritional supplements and anabolic steroids. Even papers about very serious public health issues, like the effect of body weight on adolescent academic performance. It found that white teen girls who weigh more perform worse in school. For everyone else, it's complicated.
Put that cookie down!
Even papers about animal behavior throw in a mention of Arnold here and there. Like biological effects of locomotor play, getting into shape, or something more specific. It turns out animals don't just play to get fit. It's also good for other things like motor learning. The fact that I didn't find a paper called "Is Arnold Schwarzenegger Actually a Robot? A Multidisciplinary Approach?" kind of surprised me. But maybe I just didn't get far enough into the results.
I'm a cybernetic organism.
Once he became an actor and cultural icon in his own right, a lot of papers started looking at Schwarzenegger's impact on culture as a whole. Do movie stars encourage adolescents to start smoking? Evidence from California found that, yeah, adolescents who prefer actors who smoke or whose characters smoke are more likely to pick up the habit themselves. And yeah, Arnold is one of those celebrities.
Sure, here's my invitation.
Other papers looked at his impact on culture through the lens of his identity as masculinity made flesh. Arnold Schwarzenegger, Mr. Universe, Hollywood masculinity in the search of the new man, or gender and the action heroine, hard bodies and the point of no return. Look at what make our badass movie stars so badass, and how that relates to gender norms and culture as a whole. As expected, there's lots of papers on Arnie's time as governor, also known as the Governator, and the recall election during which he won office. Papers like Somebody vs. Nobody, an exploration of the role of celebrity status in an election, looked at how his fame impacted the election. Participants showed a greater intention to vote for a candidate who was a recognizable Hollywood actor, rather than an unknown candidate, regardless of the political information provided about the candidates. And a bunch of papers examine his fame and politics from slightly different angles. Others look at his political impact, and surprisingly, most focus on his work as an environmentalist after he was governor. The making of an environmental hero, a history of eco-modern masculinity, fuel cells, and Arnold Schwarzenegger, explores how his symbolic masculine persona expanded to include compassion and responsible care for the environment. And charismatic megafauna, the growing power of celebrities and pop culture in climate change campaigns, looks at how the unendangered species of the modern celebrity is replacing the polar bear as the charismatic megafauna glamorizing climate awareness.
Now, you know that charismatic megafauna and eco-modern masculinity are phrases you can use in your everyday life.
Cool.
And in psychology, naturally, there's the Arnold Schwarzenegger effect.
Of course he has his own effect.
The study, The Arnold Schwarzenegger Effect, is strength of the victim related to misinterpretations of harm intrusions, looked at how we feel in response to a car accident involving an elderly man versus one involving a young, fit, able-bodied man like Schwarzenegger. It found that when the victim is the governator, we feel less distress and less morally wrong than we would if the victim was perceived to be more frail. It's an important finding for doctors who may misdiagnose or underweigh pain reporting in patients who otherwise appear strong and healthy.
It's not a tumor. It's not a tumor at all.
And in neuroscience, one study asked memory-impaired individuals to imagine, with as much detail as possible, Arnold Schwarzenegger interacting with a typewriter in an attic. Another asked participants to play a Pictionary-style game and draw Schwarzenegger, among other celebrities. And Arnie's face has been used as an example in a bunch of facial recognition experiments. Once you're used in a famous faces test, you kind of walk into a lifetime of scientific analysis. So at this point, I was on page 18 of the Google Scholar search and realized there were a lot of papers mentioning Schwarzenegger. I hadn't quite trusted the accuracy of the initial search. It showed tens of thousands of results. But I'd read more than 100 papers mentioning Schwarzenegger, and they just kept coming.
I mean, it's terrific, right?
Based on the types of papers I'd seen come up, even if only 54% of the results are actual academic papers, then there are approximately 15,000 papers that mention him. If I flashed one title on screen every second, this video would run for more than 4 hours. I told you it got out of hand.
Yeah, it was a real pain in the neck.
So think of this video as the curated top hits. Every study is contained within these search pages on Google Scholar. Though there are a few things that all 15,000 scientific studies have in common. Obviously, they all mention Arnold Schwarzenegger, but they do so for a reason.
From his name and image to his fame and cultural impact, he's a fascinating person and a solid example. And now he just keeps on getting used as an example so the studies can be replicated. Science builds on science. And people also have a tendency to use celebrities like Schwarzenegger and pop culture to make difficult things easier to digest.
We can be certain that no matter how many times Arnie says,
"Hasta la vista, baby."
In the world of academia, this father of eco-modern masculinity will always
be back.
I'll be back. I'll be back.
I'll be back.
I'll be back. I know.
Hey everybody, please subscribe to my new channel. It's all about the climate changing and a little bit of bodybuilding, yeah.
This is Joe Hansen, who you might know from It's Okay to Be Smart. He's one of 3 new hosts on Hot Mess, which is one of the newer shows from PBS Digital Studios. Please go and subscribe. I'll put a link down in the description.
Thanks, guys.